offside against Soyalo, and quite clearly offside. So the referee will see if there is any advantage.
Still got advantage to Blue. Offside, 19.
Well, Auckland will be happy that he is patient with his advantage there, because they just ran the risk of squandering the opportunity to use up some time and get 3 points in the process with the breeze behind them.
Smithy, I'd actually have a crack at this one, wouldn't you?
Oh, he's got to have a kick.
Yeah.
Got to use up the
just
clock.
Just use the clock up. Big chase line if it misses.
Oh, he'll kick this. It's within range for Nafee with the way he's been striking it this year, but there was almost one phase too many for them, and he might have set advantage over.
So Troy Flavel, when he gets back, will have about 3.5 to 4 minutes. Big kick this, because it means that Wellington would need to score twice. Beautifully struck.
A sensational kick. He really is in the zone. And if you get points on the board when you're only playing at 14 against 15, that just lifts the 14 guys out there. It gets the reserves all excited.
Kickoff made by Goffith. Claimed by Nicotini for Wellington. Here's Allison trying to barge ahead. Auckland trying to get him to the touchline. Neither backline has had much latitude tonight. Troy Pelotu grabbed by the collar. And back they go. Turnover ball. Eventually, perhaps. There it is. Nafiwa. Fielded by Taku.
When it goes bad, it goes really bad. He does it. At least he's got a smile. Frustration starts to kick in. They get swamped in the midfield. Sam Tuitupu, sorry, got a hand of a jersey.
Good line-out throw by Mialamu. Auckland happy to kill the clock. Nafiwa looking to step his way through. Oh, heavy traffic there.
Yeah, but he presented that ball brilliantly in that tackle situation. It makes it so easy for the guys to get to him.
This is the way to play it when you've got a 9-point lead. Taking a couple of metres each time here, Auckland, as the clock ticks on.
Leave it! Leave it! Heads off!
Troy Flavel, just a minute and 40 before he comes back. But they're doing an excellent job here, Auckland.
Yes, they're professionally winding down the clock. They're not putting it anywhere further than just round the fringes.
19 away!
Just crash and bash. They've got a 9-point lead. Wellington have got to score 2 tries. They're doing it very, very accurately and systematically. They're a well-coached outfit.
Now it's been turned over. So Wellington have an opportunity here. Smith stumbling. Getting pulled in there, which is not entirely legal.
Roll out, 3! You've fallen
straight in here. I want you to roll out. Yep, you guys have fallen over. I want you to roll out.
So, penalty to Wellington. 5 minutes remaining. They'll look for to boot it into touch. Not going to get it out there, though. Oh, Smith's knocked it down.
Conrad Smith again. He's good chasing kicks, Joey. Even if the kick was meant to find touch, Smith was alert to the fact very early it was going to.
Oh, they got out of that one. It was a fairly long kick from the middle of the track into the wind. It just held up, and then they got out of jail with that knock-on from Smith. But it was the pressure. Conrad Smith chasing. Here's the big fella back.
There's a trainer out there with water bottles for Wellington, but all he's doing is passing on instructions, it seems, and that from those tight forwards. He's giving them the message from above how they're going to play these last 6 or 7 minutes. If it's that long.
Crouch. Touch. Pause. Engage.
Waldrum is back. Here goes Goppa. Sets it up again. Now Sotialo. You have to think that Wellington's future lies out wide as Waldrum knocks it on. Maybe that's the last chance. Natiwa. Tui Tupo. Goes down in a good tackle. Ball looking to turn it over.
Play on. He wasn't held. There's nothing wrong. 18 now.
Now Moa fires it back. Nathiwa on the left boot and safely into touch. That's all that matters. It also means that it's time for Flavel to come back.
And for Wellington to make two replacements as well if they get the cards up in time. Line out first.
Over the place here. Now they shovel it out to midfield. Waldrum hands it on. Smith looking to step his way through. Gets the pass off. Good burst by Tui Pelotu. Now Conrad Smith again. Placed on the ground by Paku. Now working it into midfield with Nonu. He well contained tonight, Mata Nonu. Ball pops back again for Wepu. Here's Waldrum. Out from the 22. Wellington's last real rally in the game. Smith.
Second away. He's gone.
It's on the Auckland side. Power again. Nathiwa.
Both teams are on the ropes. Fatigue, exhaustion's kicking in. Even the
come off.
The injection of some energy, bunnies off the reserve bench, and Smithy, both sides basically emptied everything out.
Yeah, Alex Tulo and 20 for Wellington, for Thomas Waldron and Anthony Piranese as well, for John Swalger.
No tries in the second half of this game. Here's Coles busting away downfield, got the pass back nicely to Nicotini. Now here's Jacob Allison. Wellington 10 metres away.
Send away!
Throwing themselves into this ruck, Wellington.
No one, no one!
Ball left there. Oh. Here goes Wepu. It's 1 metre away. And a penalty.
Rolled out, he's blocked in there. It's out five.
Thrush waiting out on this near side. Wepu takes it. Lavave.
Get out, Blue!
Very slow ball.
12, watch! Release, Blue!
You know he's fighting, he's on his feet.
Ball been stolen. But I reckon Wellington might get it back.
Oh, that's a shambles.
Now it's with Nonu. Nonu can't quite make it.
Tom. Just going to go up and have a look at that.
Ball lost forward, I think, by Nonu. I don't think it's a problem for Auckland.
Jono, can you have a look at this, please, and tell me who's grounded the ball?
Yep, so just to see if he's grounded the ball in the scoring or what's happened. I'll check for you, mate.
Thanks, mate. No?
Well, if there are any some hands in there slowing balls down, that was the opportunity. Everyone was doing it.
Rolls forward, doesn't it? And then it's forced by an Auckland player over the goal line. So whether it's knocked back by an Auckland player, that's what they've got to decide.
Yeah. First, we're going to play the lost forward from Black.
And you take the first.
I have a decision.
Yeah, mate.
Chris, the ball has ended up being grounded in goal, so I think you should go with your original decision.
Well, mate, I don't hear that. Come through. It's been lost forward.
Four changes here for Auckland, emptying the bench. Nick White, Grayson Hart on, Lockie Munro on, and also for them, Chris Marnie in jersey 22. So 21, 20, and 17 on. Just uses up a little bit more time.
And it gives everybody a run, I suppose, Smithy.
Oh, yeah. Look at that medal in the cabinet, Nisbo. They say I was there.
Yep. Time is up, and what a season it's been for Pat Lamb,
touch,
Shane Howe,
pause,
in this
engage.
Auckland team. It's been a tough, tough final.
Crouch, touch, pause, engage.
Well, we could be here forever.
Touch,
of putting this
pause,
last
engage.
Down.
Clear it. Back, back nine. Heads up, back.
Auckland are going to get this into touch back. As quickly as they can, if they can.
Lost forward.
Ball lost forward, kicked into touch. And the title is Auckland's.
Shield locked up. They are the first side in 17 years to do the treble, and that is go undefeated throughout the season and lock up two big trophies. They've written themselves into Auckland history books and New Zealand rugby history books. They have been the form team this year. They were made to work extremely hard by a gallant and courageous Wellington side. But with dominating possession and territory, Wellington found it very hard to keep clicking over the scoreboard.
Well, let's go sideline now. Ian Smith with Sam Tuitupo.
Sam, obvious jubilation. What a special season, eh? What a way to finish it.
Oh, it is. You know, each week I've asked the boys to step up to the mark, and they have, and to finish unbeaten in the season, just tremendous work.
Yeah, you're under pressure a lot more than you had been in recent weeks, but you responded well. The defence was there, and particularly when you were down to 14.
Oh, exactly, and it comes down to you know, just the pride of the boys. You know, we knew we had one man down, but you know, the boys stuck in it and they gave it all, and at the end, you know, we came on top.
All heads at the right time.
Oh, exactly, and it comes down to, you know, to the team unity. And each week, you know, it's, we've been building on it. And tonight, what a good way to finish.
Unbeaten, Sam, unbelievable. Very competitive competition right throughout. Pressure from a lot of sides. Stevie Devine enjoying a moment with you. What a sad way for him to finish his career. But a lot of happy blokes on a night where you have to reflect because you're losing a few players, including yourself.
Yeah, exactly. And we knew this season, you know, we were losing a lot of players. But the boys really stepped up to the mark. And what a great way to finish for the boys who are leaving.
Highlight for you personally?
I guess just the team bonding at the beginning of the season. We went to Thailand. There wasn't much rugby stuff there, but it was about team bonding, and it showed. You know, it came out the whole season that the boys stayed together quite well, and we came through unbeaten.
And a little matter of a piece of valuable New Zealand rugby wood in the cabinet as well.
Oh, exactly. You know, it's always good when we win things, but just to the boys, you know, outstanding work this season.
Sam, go and join your boys. Well done. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot, Smithy. Cheers.
Yeah, smiles and jubilation all round, and why not? What a season it's been. Unbeaten in the Air New Zealand Cup. And with that, of course, goes the title. Also, the Ranfurly Shield locked safely away until next winter. And now Smithy has Piri Wepu.
Well, Piri, obviously, despondency on your side of the ledger. You guys gave it everything tonight.
Yeah, we knew it was going to be a tough fight tonight, especially up here on Auckland's home ground. And you know, the better team won on the day, and you know, they were a lot more hungry than what we were. So we tried our best right to the last minute, and you know, obviously we didn't come off with the result we wanted.
They don't give you many opportunities, do they? You didn't spend enough time perhaps in the 22 to capitalise.
Yeah, I guess, you know, we're just young and inexperienced, you know, at finals level. But you know, I guess this is an experience for the young guys to you know, sort of hold high and make sure that they, you know, come next year if they're still in the team, that you know, they finish well.
No doubt that you deserve to be in this final because you played some terrific rugby towards the end of the season.
Yeah, I guess in the second half of the season we were told to sort of step up in our top five. You know, they worked hard on their game, and most of the credit goes to them. You know, they worked hard throughout the season, and you know, it was a big ups for them.
Terrific way to finish the season from Wellington's point of view. Okay, you don't get the trophy tonight, but as you say, there's plenty ahead for your young side.
Yeah, there definitely is. So hopefully next year we can come back to the final and actually come off with the trophy.
Hurry, go and shake a few hands. Well done, mate. Thanks.
Cheers.
So that crowns a great season for the Auckland rugby side. They've won the Air New Zealand Cup final in 2007 here at Eden Park by 23 points to 14.
And Piri, please, Eden Park, put your hands together for this Wellington team. I'd now like to call up the match officials for tonight's game. Did an outstanding job given the conditions. Chris Pollock, your referee. The touch judges were Vinnie Munro and Keith Brown. And the TMO for tonight, who had to make a few decisions, Jonathan White. Well done to the officials. I'd now like to call on Cam Wallace, representing the Air New Zealand, your sponsors for this great tournament, to come forward and say a few words.
Thanks, Ian. Well, tonight was a fitting end to a fantastic Air New Zealand Cup season, and well done, Auckland. Congratulations, it's been a fantastic year, unbeaten, and just a great day tonight, and we really appreciate the way you've gone. Congratulations to the guys from Wellington. They've had a really hard road to the final and they played some good rugby in tough conditions. I also want to take the opportunity to thank all the 14 teams that contributed to the Air New Zealand Cup. It's been a long season but a really successful one. We really appreciate the commitment and the desire and the support of grassroots rugby in New Zealand. So thank you all for your support of Air New Zealand. We really appreciate New Zealand rugby support, and well done, Auckland. We know you're going to celebrate long and hard tonight. Thank you.
Well done, Cam. Well done, Air New Zealand. Thank you very much for your support. Okay, Eden Park. Okay, Auckland. This is the moment you've worked very hard for all year. You are the champions of 2007 for the Air New Zealand Cup. I'd like to call up your captain in his very last game for Auckland, Sam Tuitupoa, to come forward, receive his medal, and introduce the champion side. Sammy.
Thank you. Just to my boys tonight, you know, each week I ask you guys to step it up another level, and tonight you guys did, and what a great way to finish off a tremendous season. To guys like Moli and Marnie, you know, you guys were asked to step out tonight because of, you know, the guys like Kevin Mialamu and Ice turning back, coming back, and so, you know, you guys have been a great team man this whole season, so full credit to you guys. And also credit to Paddy, Howie, Machine, Kim, Peachy, JD, Machine, and sometimes Killy, and also Griddle for the hard work you guys put in this season. You know, and tonight's is for you guys. To the supporters, thanks a lot for your loyalty, turning up week in and week out. And tonight, this win's for you guys. And also, just on behalf of the guys that are leaving, and myself, we'd just like to thank Auckland and supporters for everything you guys have done for us. Thank you very much. And I just want to introduce our players. Simon Etamwe Bell. John Afoa. Daniela Case-Moore. Mecca, Issa, Flavel, Tony Ward, Brett Ward, Chris Marnie, Mahoney, Daniel Big Bum Bray, Young Grayson, Lachlan, Iron Shoulder Benson, Goldfish J, Freak, Bradley Mika, Curtis Ayu, Old School Nick White, Chris Hurd, Kaino, Kim Mialamu, Isaiah Semo Tuyava, Daniel Smith, Steve Devine, Darren Wickham, Onosai Alva, Tasisa Lavea, Stanley, Okanimba, Winnie, Stanley, Charlie, Pamwina, Chris, Jamie, and Fred Artinga. Our coach, Pat Lamb. This other guy, Shane Howarth. And Machine.
Right, before you go, Sammy, I need to call up Peter Burke, Cam Wallace, to hand over the Air New Zealand trophy to Sammy Tuitupoa and the Auckland team. Sammy, you've forgotten something. Time to enjoy, celebrate, drive safely.
Yes, a job well done by Auckland. There was a lot at stake tonight. they've come through with flying colours. It was a tough battle in the final. So many of these guys won't wear the blue and white again.
Well, a very happy bunch of men. One of the most important aspects in this wonderful game of ours is enjoyment, and you'll find that you'll enjoy your work and you'll perform better when you're a happy team. They've travelled very well this year, Grant. They were just 6 points ahead of Wellington after the first 40 minutes, and then they eased that out to a 9-point difference in the second half.
Well, Stu, of the squad that was named at the start of the season, the players that won't be back, Angus McDonald, Simone Taumoipiau, Brent Ward, Brad Meeker, Doug Howlett, Ali Williams, Darren Woodcombe, Steve Devine, James Somerset, David Gibson, Tasessa Lavia, Sam Tuitupo. Now, not all of those players are involved tonight, but it's a changing of the guard, and they're going to enjoy this while they can, and good luck to them.
Quite rightly, and you can't stop the flood of top-line players leaving our provincial scene, our national scene, our Super 14 scene. But when you look what Auckland have got coming through, David Smith, Benson Stanley, Taniela Mola, you know, Jay Williams is a young guy, Curtis Hayo is young, John Afar is just 24 years of age. So they've got young guys coming through, but it is a huge hole, Grant, when a whole bunch of experienced players leave at the end of one season.
Saluting the fans, the loyal fans. Well, the Ranfurly Shield's got an earring as well tonight. Was the scene as the final whistle blew at Eden Park, and that's what all the hard work is about. These guys have been together for about 6 months. That's the other side of the story.
That's the sad of the other side of the equation, is both just disappointment that they fired the best shots.
So Auckland win the title 23 to 14.